and welcome back to the 30-day Uke Course. Today we are going to layer several of the things that we've done throughout the course, so I hope that you are ready. Make sure that your ukulele is tuned. I really like to emphasize on the tuning and that this is not good enough because every time you're playing your instrument, you're training your ear to hear that as right. And so I prefer if you tune every day so that you train your ear, because then when your ukulele truly is out of tune, you will be able to distinguish that. Wow, let's just get started with the playing. One of the patrons asked for a 12-bar blues lesson, so here we are. By the way, if you want to join Patreon, I will link it down below. The 12-bar blues is organized into groups of 4 beats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and it's just 12 of those. That's why it's called 12-bar. Each group of 4 is called a bar. In each bar, you're playing a specific chord. Thankfully, there are only 3 chords in the entire thing. To figure out which chords those are, we're gonna go back to the C major scale, and this connects together. So in the C major scale, we have notes C, D, E, F, G, A, B, and ending on C. For the 12-bar blues, you're going to start on your first chord, or the first step of the C major scale, because we're in the key of C. So that would be C, and you play that for 4 bars, okay? 2, 3, 4. Then you go to the 4 chord in the key. What is the 4th step of the C major scale? F. So, and we're gonna do that for 2 bars. 1, 2. Then for the next 2 bars, we go back to our 1 chord. The last line of the 12-bar blues is the most interesting in my opinion. We go to the 5 chord, which is a G. 4. 1. And back to the 5. Now, this all sounds a little too cheerful for it to be the blues. The blues has to have that emotion. So I went to the blues ukulele pro that I know, and that's Tyler from 10 Thumbs Pro, and I said, Tyler, can you give me one of your easy introductory blues lessons, and then I will tell everyone to come and watch your whole playlist, because he has a whole playlist on not only the blues, but how to improvise. And he said, yeah, of course, here you go. So this is coming from Tyler, 10 Thumbs Pro. He turned all of the chords into 7th chords, and that makes them all so much more interesting. We have, instead of C, we have C7. And that already sounds so much better. So C7, 2, 3, 4, F7. So much better. Super duper 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 fast, but I'll break it down and do it with you right now. I just kind of wanted to demonstrate. Okay, so we have C7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 4. Next, we have F7. So you can play F7 2 different ways. You can play it with 3 fingers, or you can play it with the 4th finger, which gives you that high note. I leave this one up to your preference. I recommend that as you're switching from C7 to F7, first land the F and continue the strum, don't stop, and then add the fingers. Look. And it's okay, like nothing's gonna happen if you are a little late with the ring and pinky. So let's do line 2. 1, 2, 1, 2, ready, go. Now let's do line 4, super slow. 1, 2, 1, 2, line 4, go. Okay, I didn't do the last bar because I want to teach you a little style choice that I have. I like to make a little rest on the downbeat, so on beat 1. And I do and 2 and 3 and 4 and I'm gonna play that whole line, and you'll hear that little rest and the impact that it has, okay? Okay, so let's try to play the entire thing. Here we go. 1, 2, 1, 2, ready, go. 3, 4. Download the resource, you'll see a list of all of the scales slash key signatures, and you'll be able to take the 1, 4, and 5 of any of those and plug it into the blues format so that you can really play the blues in many, many, many different ways. So let's, for example, go to A. Okay, so we have A, B, C sharp, D, E. We only need those, right, because it's 1, 4, and 5. So A is the 1, B, C sharp, D is the 4, and E is the 5. So the first chord is A, but we're going to make it A7 to make it sound more bluesy. Now we need to go to the 4, that's D7, and the easy way to play it is this way. Back to A7. Need to go to the 5, A, B, C sharp, D, E, that's a 5, and then the 4, and then the 1. So that is E7, D7, and then A7. And what you just did is called transposing. Changing the key of a song, and this is a song, is transposing. So if you would like to transpose the blues to different key signatures, you can do it now with the chart that I've attached and with the template that's on the printable resource. And the resource is free, by the way, so please, please pick it up. Okay, so just for fun, let's do that A. Here we go. 1, 2, 1, 2, ready, go. 12-bar blues format, you learned how to transpose or how to change the key or the chords of a song, and you also learned that there is a wonderful musician named Tyler who is making really, really, really great blues resources. And if you want to go down that rabbit hole of like blues and soloing and strumming and all that, I will add his card on the other side of the screen and I will link his videos down below as well. Tyler, thank you so much for the printable resource that you allowed us to add to this. Have fun with your homework today, and I will see you in tomorrow's video. Sayonara!